Hi, and in today's video, I'm going to show you how you can select different layouts for your PowerPoint presentation. So when you open your software, you'll come across this page here. Just simply select the design that you want and then just click create. So then PowerPoint will go ahead and insert your design and then will automatically put in a default layout. Now you can go ahead and utilize this layout. So if you're happy with the layout of the first slide, you can just go up to New Slide here. You can either just click on it and PowerPoint will make an automatic layout selection for you. Now let's go back, Command or Control Z. If you use the New Slide drop-down, you can see we've got a lot more to choose from in terms of our layout. So let's say, for example, we wanted to select this slide here. And this will give you the options to insert some videos or some pictures or some text or some graphs. So click to add the title. And then here we can go down and select one of these. So let's say we'd like to select a picture. We can click on the picture, select a picture and click insert. Now, once you've added your picture, you can see that PowerPoint has now generated lots of other design ideas on the right hand side here. And you can simply go down and scroll to see if there's one that you like better than the one on the screen. If you do, just select it and PowerPoint will automatically change it for you. So let's say you've now got this design and you decided, well, actually, I just want to add some text. You can just click at the top here and begin to add some text. Once you've added your text, you can go ahead and change this text box. So you can reduce the size of it. You can move it and you can also produce a copy. So select it, hold down your Alt or Option key and then click and drag. And then you can produce an exact replica where you can go ahead and add further text. Now let's go on to a new slide. And from here, let's just add a blank slide. And from here, we can actually construct our own layout. So go up to Insert, Text Box, click and draw out a text box. Now we can center this text box by selecting it, going to Shape Format, go to Align, click Align to Center, double click inside the text box and simply type your title. To center this text, go to the Home tab and go along to this icon here, Center Text. Let's just quickly change the size of this font, go to Home, go along to the font area, click on this option here, increase font size. There we go. And now insert. Let's go to picture. Let's go to stock images and then just select an image and click insert. Now, as you can see, this image is too big. So what we need to do is grab the corner and just reduce the size of it. And then we can place this anywhere in this slide. Now, as you can see, as I move this, it will click into the center. You can see those bars just appearing, those guide bars. And then again, if I move it up and down, it will click into position so it's perfectly centered. Now, you may not want this perfectly centered, which is absolutely fine. We can move it over to the left or right. And then once again, we can go to Insert, Text Box, click and draw out a text box. In here, we can add some more text. Once we've added our text, we can ensure that this text is perfectly lined up with this picture here because we can just pull this box down a bit. You'll notice to move these text boxes, you just need to hover over the outline and your cursor will change to a double-headed arrow. Just move it down roughly in line. Select this box, hold down your Command or Control key and select this image as well. Go to Shape or Picture Format, it doesn't matter. Go to the Align tool, click on the drop down and now select Align to Middle. And now you can see these two boxes are perfectly lined up and it's lined up to the center. If you want to ensure that the whole lot is centered, click on this image, hold down your Command or Control key, click on this image, go to Group, select Group, then go to Align and Align to Center. And it will ensure all of this is lined up to the center of your slide. Once again, if we just go to New Slide and we click blank, then again, we can insert shapes as well. So if we click on Shapes and we can insert a rectangle, can insert that anywhere on our slide. Once we've selected it, if I just click away, you can see there's a darker border and a lighter fill. We can change all of that, just click on it, go up to Shape Format, go to Shape Outline. I'm actually going to get rid of the Shape Outline and just change the colour of the shape fill. So I'm going to use a light grey. Now in these shapes, you can move them anywhere you want in the slide. You can make them bigger or smaller by resizing them. You can duplicate them, just select it, hold down the Alt key, click and drag. You can also align them as we did before, just hold down the Command or Control key, click on them both, go to Align, Align to Center, perfectly lined up. And of course you can use these to add some backgrounds to your text boxes. So draw out your shape, go to Insert, Text Box, click and drag out the text box, add your text, there we go. In fact, we can pull the text to the center of here. Let's just pull this text box down a little bit. And then let's just click on the background shape. There we are. We can align them both, select the text box, then hold down the Command or Control key, select the shape box, go to Shape Format, go to Align, Align to Center, Align, Align to Middle. And then if you wanted to change the background color of the text box, then click away, click back on the text box, go to Shape Fill, go to White. Now you can see the text has vanished. Press Command or Control A to select all of your text. Go to the Home tab, go to Font Color, click on the drop down and select Black. And then we can see that this text isn't quite in the center, so we'll move the box again, select the text box, select the shape box, go to Shape Format, Align, Align to Center, Align, Align to Middle. Click away and you can see how that layout looks. Now you can see the text is quite close to the edge of that text box if you want that to change. So all you need to do is select the text box, go to Shape Format, go along to Format Pane, and here you'll have lots of different options. We need to make sure we're on Format Shape. We can close down Stock Images, go to Shape Options, and then go to Size and Properties. Click on this one here. Then go down to Text Box, and then you can see Left Margin. You can see it's 0.25, and the top and bottom margins are 0.13. So let's just change all of those to 1, just for the time being. You can see how this works. Press Enter, and now you can see that we've got a centimetre margin around all of our text. And you can see if I try and nudge that, it bounces back because it wants to fit all the text in. So let's reduce the size of the text, select it all, go to the Home tab, go to this Reduce Font Size tool here, we'll do that twice, and then we'll move that into the centre here again. So let's go ahead again, select the text box, select the outer shape, Shape Format, Align, Align to Center, Align, Align to Middle. We can also add other icons, so select icons. Now in icons over here, you can see icons here, you can actually do a search here. So if I just put in maps, you can see I have a range of maps on offer to me here. But you can choose anything from science to animals to pets, anything you like. Just click on the image you want, click Insert, and then you can move that icon anywhere you want to. You can resize it, and also you can rotate it with this little circle at the top here as well. You can add other icons as well, click Insert. And just as a side note with these icons, you can change the color, click on them, go to Graphics Format, click on Graphics Fill, and then you can change them to a color of your choice. Again, if you want them all perfectly lined up, select them, hold down the Command or Control key to select all, go to Graphics Format, Align, Align, distribute horizontally, so make sure they're distributed equally. a line to middle. Then if we just group them together, they're just one big group there, and then we can just simply line them up to the middle, click on the drop down, align to center. Then all those icons are lined up to the center. So I hope that's all helped you today. If it has, please subscribe and have a great day.